What's up, guys? Jimmy Your Chaos, welcome back to another Top 10. Today, we are going to be going over the top 10 guns that sucked in COD history, picked by you guys, put in order by me. Real quick, I'm going to do like I did last time. If you guys didn't know, I relaunched Chaos Plays On, and if you guys show me proof on Twitter that you guys are subscribed to the channel, I will retweet and reply to everybody that shows me proof. So link in the description, go subscribe. I'm doing a bunch of Let's Plays. There's top 5s, top 10s over there. There's a lot going on with the channel, but let's jump right into this. We will have some honorable mentions at the end. Drop a like on the video if you guys would. And at number 10 from LAX Boylan, hashtag Chaos Top 10, has to be the Cheekum from Black Ops 2. That thing is a marshmallow shooter. I agree. It also sounds like a fart cannon. Now remember, some of these you guys, some of you probably have personal attachments to, and they're going to be like, this was the best gun in the world. I don't know what you guys are talking about, but understand the masses, the community, picked these. These were tweeted multiple times, and then they were put in order. So keep that in mind, and this was going to be guns that we wanted to give back to COD history, but it turned into kind of everybody was tweeting me the sucky ones, so I decided to turn it to a guns that sucked in COD history instead. Kind of went on the fly just to make it as smooth as I could. Coming in at number 9 from Yes I'm Baby Wes, hashtag Chaos Top 10, the China Lake from Black Ops 1. I mean, who would use it? Well, unless you were trolling, you wouldn't use this. And the thing I remember about the China Lake was specifically that when you equipped it and you put it in your hands, it instantly felt like you had lead boots and were running in quicksand. And I know, I guess it was a heavy gun. It was like basically a piece of artillery in your hand, but you ran so slow with this thing. If they would have gave you some speed, maybe this thing would have been a viable option. Coming in at number 8 from It's Trixer, the AMR-9 in Advanced Warfare is a complete waste of space. Absolutely horrible. Laugh out loud. I wanted to give the AMR-9 a chance. I did a video of the Dynamo Elite version a long time ago, and it wasn't horrible, but he's right. It just didn't compare when you went to the others, and I wanted to give it a chance. A 5-round burst gun, it was cool. It was a neat gun, but it definitely never lived up to the hype. Coming in at number 7 from Dog Fox Daniel, the S12 from Black Ops 2. Terrible range and damage. I felt like I was shooting marshmallows at the enemy. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. I remember equipping this, trying to get a gameplay on Nuketown with this thing, and it was absolutely horrible. If you have a shotgun, you should be able to do some significant damage to people if they are close to you. And this thing, you literally had to spray every shell you had to get the kill, and then be reloading constantly. It was definitely a piss poor. It does not represent the shotgun family very well. Coming in at number 6 from Oreo, best name so far on Twitter, the Dragunov should be banned. It has absolutely no point in existing any COD. Not only does it exist, they throw it in almost every Call of Duty title that we have to date. I don't understand why. Maybe it's a balance thing. You have to have all aspects on the spectrum covered with sniper rifles. You have to have the strong ones, and then you have to have the crappy ones. And the Dragunov always seemed to fit in there. It was a hit marker machine, and it was ugly to me. Now, I'm starting a hate fest with it. Some of you probably think it's a beautiful piece of gunmanship, but to me, I don't like it. And I understand exactly why it made the list. Coming in at number 5 from the Banter King 88, the SWAT 556, hashtag Chaos Talk Tim. He's referring to the SWAT from Black Ops 2. A lot of people tweeted this gun at me. I do understand it's definitely lower in the power levels compared to a lot of other guns from Black Ops 2, but there are a lot of beast guns in Black Ops 2, so if a gun is going to suck, it's really going to show in that game if it's pitted against all the others. Coming in at number 4, and so many people tweeted this, Flatten Sage, the F2000 from Modern Warfare 2, absolutely terrible. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Now, I know a lot of people are, there's going to be people in the comment section to say the F2000 was amazing. The high rate of fire was awesome. You're absolutely right. But when you squeeze the trigger and the gun shoots up to the moon, you have some issues with recoil. It's a fun gun, but I understand why it's on the list. I understand why a lot of people tweeted at me, and I also understand there's going to be some diehard supporters of the F2000, so keep that in mind. Now let's get into the top 3. Cyclone DG, the MAC-11 from Black Ops 1, horrible weapon. Maybe my pick for the worst weapon. I did a video on this a long time ago. I used to do a challenge series, and this was way back in the day. First year I was on YouTube, And you guys picked this Mac 11 for me to use in like a video camera spike on Black Ops. And I remember putting my spike down and then some enemy teabagging in the video camera spike, which was funny. But the Mac 11 was horrible. And I think you could dual wield this thing and it was even worse than that. It literally had a drop off range of like 4 feet, it felt like. This thing was very, very hard to use and very frustrating. Coming in at number 2 from Doodler Fox, hashtag Chaos Top 10, the Black Ops WA 2000. I could do more damage with a weak fart than this turd of a gun. The WA, the only cool thing about this gun is that it has a little face on the lid cap of the scope. Other than that, it's a bad version of the Dragunov, in my opinion. You've got the wood stock on both of these, and this thing was just absolutely a hit marker machine. I'm sure snipers just, hey, I'm going to use the WA 2000 and I'm going to go against the grain and get some really good gameplay, and then you just throw your controller at the TV. But coming in at number 1, your pick, kind of, for the gun that sucked the most, from EthanMatt01, the EPM3 from AW. It's just terrible. I did a video saying this could be the worst gun in COD history. I think Drifter even said this may be the worst gun in COD history. Just bad. Bad, bad on all aspects across the board. Definitely understand why this is in the number 1 spot. Coming in with a couple honorable mentions really quick. Core Steven, the NA45 worst sniper ever. Enough said. I never understood why you had to shoot one bullet and then shoot another one to make it explode. I guess it's innovative. I don't know. Maybe people enjoy it. It feels like more of a trolling sniper rifle than an actual viable one to me. But whatever, I don't think it'll ever happen again. And then the other one is from Shoal Gabriel. And he says, the Scorpion from Black Ops 1, just pitiful, had barely no ammo, very high fire rate. And I think you could throw some extended mags on this bad boy and it wasn't as bad. Some people did like the Scorpion, but I definitely understand why it wasn't one of your favorites, Mr. Gabriel. So there you go, guys. Drop a like on the video if you would. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to check out Chaos Plays On. Tweet me a picture. Show me that you're subscribed over there, and I will show you guys some love on Twitter as well. And I'll see you later.